The months-long attempt to rewrite what happened on the Capitol 6th has been horrifying from the very beginning. The idea that the supporters of a political party would storm a government building to assassinate leaders and try to overthrow the results of an election. And then because they failed, even though they were joined in that effort in a different form by Republican legislators, then the Republicans get to just play PR for them for months. All of that is horrifying, especially when they try to imply that there was nothing violent about what happened. Well, it very much was, and new footage should not be required. We've already seen so much, but that said, there is some new body cam footage that I want to show you.
There is a scuffle with the insurrectionists. He's tased and you hear him screaming as one of the insurrectionists says, "Got one."
Jason, that is just horrifying.
How can you not get emotional watching that? You know, how can you not sit and see someone pleading for his life, right? Because his job is to protect people, John, right? And so you have these people that are these Bobby Johnny Davis that are just I got one. And then the dude says, "I have kids."
That's what you say when you think that you're about to be killed and you're trying to stop people from murdering you.
100%. I don't mean to get emotional. It's just I think about my brother who's in the service, and these people who give their lives to protect us. And because these douchebags feel a way about an election, something that happens every 4 years, and I get it in politics. Yes, politics has an effect on all of us, guys. It does. But if you just really strip away what politics is, it's never worth someone's life. You know, it's never worth someone's life. And that dude, and then someone comes in to try to help this guy up. Guaranteed, he woke up that morning not thinking that was gonna be how his day was going to end. And praise God that I think he's still alive. I'm not sure what happened after the video. He's still alive, but it just infuriates me that people think that that's okay. I can't even articulate what I'm feeling right now watching that, but it's hyper infuriating.
Yeah, well, I think what you're feeling is what basically every rational, sane person with an ounce of empathy feels. That was Officer Michael Fanone. He suffered a heart attack and a concussion. He's now dealing with a traumatic brain injury and post-traumatic stress disorder.
Of course.
Pretty reasonably. Because he thought that he was in the process of being murdered. He was screaming in agony. He was begging and pleading with that insane murderous crowd to not kill him. And thankfully, some of the people there stopped the others from killing him. That's their people, though. like, have they turned against the movement? Do they think, oh my God, what are we doing? Mm-hmm. Like, if I was in a crowd of Bernie Sanders supporters and then some of them started killing people and I had to stop them, I don't think I'd get the victim away and then say, okay, let's go back to pushing for Medicare for all. I would have a few questions about the people that were in that crowd at that point.
100%.
But remember, Jason, what you just watched was a normal day at the Capitol, like as if tourists were there. The officer seems to disagree. He seems to have had a day that was anything other than normal. But all of that is known. That body cam footage is new, but Michael Fanone has been talking for months about what happened to him there. And now there are Republicans who have much more high profile, access to the media whenever they want, that will lie about it, that will pretend that incredible, horrific suffering that he just experienced, and it will have effects on him for God knows how many years,
right,
didn't exist because it's convenient to them politically to pretend that.
And how re-traumatizing, John, is that? Not being believed and made to seem like you're a liar when, as we just saw in that video, his life could have, and he could have been critically injured. And that's like, hey, the lesser of the two very evils, or murdered, and his two kids would be yep, not have a father, and his wife would be a widow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But they're just gonna keep lying, and like they tried every way that they could to overturn the election. If you want to, if like maybe you're just a really optimistic person, if you want to believe that was a one-time thing, and when they lose more elections in the future, they won't do things like this, that they won't overturn it if they somehow can. Well, you can choose to do that. But I would say that the public relations campaign that's being waged by right-wing media and Republican politicians to protect the people you just watched in that video is all the evidence you need to know that was just the opening blows of the war on democracy. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.